Hello friends, today we will learn about units and SI units. We will cover introduction to units, MKS, CGS and FPS systems, SI units, fundamental and supplementary units, derived units with examples, and at last special names of SI units. What are units? To measure any physical quantity, we need a fixed unit value of that quantity. For example, to measure the distance between two points, we need a standard unit such as meter. The distance between these two points is 2 centimeters. So here, centimeter is the unit of distance. We can also measure distance in different units as well, such as kilometers, miles, centimeters, millimeters, etc. Kilometer and miles are big units. We use kilometers and miles to measure distance between two cities. Centimeters and millimeters are small units, so we use these two units for small distances. MKS system. What is MKS system? Here M is for meter, and K is for kilogram, and S is for second. So this system is actually based on three basic units: meter, kilogram, and second. SI units are also based on these three units and also on MKS system. Here we measure length in meters, we measure time in seconds, same way we measure mass in kilogram. Symbols are M, S, and KG. For areas, equation is length times width. So, its unit will be meter times meter. So it becomes meter squared, and formula of volume is length times width times height. Meter times meter, that equals meter cubed. Our unit of volume here is meter cubed. Next system is CGS system. This system used for small quantities, like C for centimeters, G for gram, and S for second. Here length is measured in centimeter, its symbol is cm. Mass is measured in gram and its symbol is Z. Time is measured in seconds, its symbol is S. Area is measured, like we will use again, length time width, that equals centimeter times centimeter. So it times centimeter, that equals centimeter squared. And for volume, length times width times height, that equals centimeter times centimeter times centimeter, that equals centimeter cubed or centimeter cube. We can use it as a symbol. This is the cube symbol, like this. For a square, we use two at the top. Next is FPS system. This system is basically used in USA. It's based on three basic units. Foot, F stands for foot, P stands for pound, and S stands for second. Length is measured in foot or feet. Just note down, foot or feet are the same thing. Its symbol is FT. Mass is measured in pound, its symbol is LB. Time is measured in second, and its symbol is S. area will be measured in foot time foot, that is foot squared, and volume will be measured in foot times foot, that is foot cubed or ft cubed. What are SI units? The unit system which is used universally in scientific community is called as SI units. S stands for system, I stands for international. So the full form of SI unit is International System of Units. This SI system is based on 7 fundamental units and 2 supplementary units. These units are also called as base units. First fundamental unit is meter, which is used to measure length. Second is kilogram, which is used to measure mass. Third is second, which is used to measure time. Fourth is ampere, which is used to measure electric current. Fifth is Kelvin, which is the SI unit of temperature. Sixth one is mole, which is used to measure amount of substance. Candela for luminous intensity. And two more supplementary units which are added later. First is radian, which is unit of plane angle. Second is steradian, which is unit of solid angle. Derived units. Derived units are combination of fundamental units or base units. We have learned 7 fundamental units and base units. So like meter per second is a derived unit because this unit is made of meter and second. The same way, meter per second square is also made by meter and second times second. So these units are made by base units or fundamental units. So these units are called as derived units. Let's take an example. So how to derive unit of velocity? So for that, we need to use formula of velocity, that is distance over time. Here we will plug in SI unit of distance and SI unit of time, that is second. Derived unit of velocity is meter per second. We can derive units of any quantity using this method. So let's take another example. For acceleration, you know formula of acceleration equals change in velocity over change in time. So what we'll do here, we plug in SI unit of velocity, that is meter per second, and then SI unit of time, so that is second. That becomes meter per second times second, and that equals meter per second square. So derived unit of acceleration equals meter per second square. Let's take another example of force. So formula of force equals mass times acceleration. Plug in SI unit of mass, that's kilogram, and SI unit of acceleration, we found it meter per second square. So this becomes kilogram meter per second square. So derived unit of force equals kilogram meter per second square. There are few units which have special names instead of writing them in fundamental units. Like force, we don't write kilogram meter per second square. Instead, everywhere you will see newtons as a unit of force. The same way, actual derived unit of energy is kilogram meter square per second square. But we generally use a special name for energy, and that is joule. The same way, unit of power has a special name, it's watt. Unit of electric charge is coulomb. For frequency, it's hertz. For pressure, it's pascal. We write the symbols like PA. Atmospheric pressure is here 1.01 times 10 raised to the power 5 pascal. So for voltage, we use volt or V, 3 volts or 4 volts. For capacitance, we use farad, special names. For electric resistance, we use ohms. In some circuits, you have seen 3 ohm resistance or 4 ohm resistance. For conductance, we use mho or siemens. For magnetic field, we use tesla. For magnetic flux, we use weber, in short form WB. For inductance, we use henry. I hope you understand this topic now in better way. If you have any kind of question on this topic, please ask question in the comment box which is given below. Thank you.